Hi everyone. In this video, we'll be looking at how to use FileBird Pro with Avada. FileBird is a WordPress media management plugin that gives you the ability to create virtual folders and helps you organize your website media content effectively without breaking any permalinks. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with all the latest videos like this one. And if you don't want to miss one, click the bell icon to get notifications of all new videos on our channel. Okay, let's begin. FileBird is the latest premium plugin to be bundled with Avada and is 100% free with your purchase. As mentioned, FileBird Pro is a media management plugin and gives you a range of tools to manage your WordPress media library. Let's look at how to install it and what it can do. As with all bundled plugins in Avada, it's incredibly simple to install. Just head to Avada, Plugins, Add-ons, and look for the FileBird plugin. Mouse over it and click on the install link. That's it. The plugin will now install. Once that's done, if we head straight to the media library, we can see that FileBird has indeed been installed. Don't forget to give a review for our good friends at Ninja Team, but I'll close that so we can focus on the features. If you'd like to migrate to FileBird from another media library manager, you can also do that. FileBird allows you to import the media structure from a range of other plugins, such as Enhanced Media Library, WP Media Folder, WordPress Media Library Folders, and Real Media Library Folders. For more details on that, visit the link in the description below. The key feature of the plugin is FileBird's resizable and sortable sidebar, which is added to the WordPress Media Library and allows you to create any number of virtual folders with which to organize your media content. FileBird can help you with uploading new files, managing and moving your existing files, and rearranging folders, all with drag-and-drop simplicity. Let's organize this media library here on the Avada Consultant demo to see how easy it is to use. Let's start by creating some folders for our files to be organized into. I'll start by making a folder called People. I'll just click on New Folder and call it People. To save the folder, you can click Save or just hit Enter on your keyboard. I'll make another one called Logos, and one called Animations, another one called Graphics, and a final one called Office Images. Okay, so now I've created 5 virtual folders. If we right-click on them, we get a menu with some useful functions like New Folder, which would create a folder inside this one, as well as Rename, Cut, Paste, and Delete. We can also move these folders around with drag and drop, either at the parent level or into other folders to make them subfolders. There's not much point organizing them alphabetically as there is a powerful sort function at the top here, which we can use to sort both folders and files in many different ways. These sorting options would really come into their own with a media library with hundreds of images. With a library this small, it's limited as to what makes sense to do, but in this case, it might be a good idea to combine some of these folders. I'll drag Logos and Animations into Graphics to make them subfolders. Obviously, you can design the folder structure however you like. You might prefer to organize your files based on where they are used in your site, rather than by content type. It's all very flexible and up to your own individual preferences. You can create unlimited folders and subfolders with FileBird, so even the most complex structures are possible. Now I have my folder structure, let's look at how I can move these existing files into the various folders. Okay, let's start with People. There is a bulk select button at the top of the media library here, so I'll click that and start selecting. You can select one at a time, or shift-click to select contiguous images. Once I have my selection done, I can just drag them over to the People folder. So that removes them from the uncategorized folder, and we can see the number of images there are now in the People folder just next to it. So with Bulk Select still active, let's move the others. I'll select the 3 animations and move them. Then I'll take the Office Images, the Graphics, and finally the Logos. Okay, so now there's only one file left in the uncategorized folder, and that's the custom icon set upload file, so I'm not going to worry about that one. I'll also now cancel out of the bulk select mode. So now we can navigate around in the folders to see the files separately. We can see all of them still in the All Files folder at the top, or we can drill down into the individual folders to see them separately. On a website with a lot of images, this plugin really would be amazing. So that's moving files. What about when you upload them? I have the People folder selected here. So if I click on Add New while I am in that folder, then the image I upload will automatically go into that folder. I'll just add new, select a file, and say OK. Now Charlie isn't exactly a person, but almost. If you use the list view in the media library, then even if you're not in a specific folder, when you click on add new, there is a choose folder option at the top left. So you can easily decide where images go when they are uploaded. You could of course also just upload them and sort them later. Moving files around is also simple. For example, if we decided that this image in Office Images really should be in People, we can just drag and drop it into that folder. And the Bulk Select option is there if you want to move multiple files. There are even a couple of settings up here next to the Sort icon, which allow you to bulk select your folders or choose the default Startup folder. There are very few other settings in FileBird, but you can find these at Settings, FileBird. If you have multiple users on your site and you'd like each user to have their own folders, there's an option for that. There's also an uninstall option to remove all data, but otherwise there's not a lot to do here. As you can see, FileBird is a really useful media management plugin, particularly in situations where you have a lot of images to manage. Okay, this concludes our video on how to use FileBird Pro with Avada. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up with all the latest videos. And if you have any questions or need assistance, please create a support ticket and our team will gladly assist you. As always, we want to thank you for choosing Avada.